of my interview with USC's new President Folt. She took us on a tour of the newest school on campus and shared some insight into the workings of this city within a city. Population, 47,000. Looking at this modern environment we're in, 1880, this school was begun. 12 presidents there have been. You're the first woman. I was just so excited. You know, it's such a privilege to be the first and to come to this amazing university and get to be a part of it. But I love it because I get to be with students and have them open up and see that women can run universities and they could see themselves running universities. So it's really a privilege.
People don't realize what a big job this is. It's like running a municipality, right?
I mean,
there's a real estate department, there's an energy department. There's everything that it takes in city governance.
That's right.
In the university.
Absolutely.
But you're also privileged to work with and on behalf of some really smart students. Where we're sitting right now, tell me about this facility and this program.
You know, this Iommi and Young Academy is unlike anything I've ever seen. Every space, every place is an innovation center. You can stop and chat with a friend and write on the wall and come up with a new experiment. They've got these amazing laboratories where they can build things, create things. Students are putting out companies. They're out working in the world, whether it's social entrepreneurship or building out a high-tech product.
How do you feel about your engineering department? 50% women now. That's something.
I just think that's such great news. This is something that I've learned since I've been here. You know, it's the most diverse of the big research universities. You know, so we already have incredible diversity. Experience 47,000 students with 47,000 different experiences.
It's extremely amazing because, of course, you have to be able to see people who look like you in a space that you want to thrive in. And I myself am a part of the National Society of Black Engineers, and I also am a part of the Center of Engineering Diversity that does have a space for women in engineering. And so as opposed to just having that title or having that good news, there actually are the resources for students to feel like they belong in this community.
And your film school has actually become a resource as it delved into its own study of diversity in the film industry.
Yes, they have real interest there. They're also really leading the pack in ethics. There isn't anything that compares with the arts here. Everyone wants to have something to do with this amazing creative economy that is Los Angeles. And people are so generous. Producers, screenwriters, people come over and they work with these students. So just imagine you're a first year student and you're getting to work with someone who's developing the set or the lighting on some wonderful new production.
Homelessness and hunger are the issues of our time, and even among college students, 20% of community college students experience homelessness, and 40% of Cal State students experience some form of hunger, and those things exist even on a campus that's perceived as so wealthy as USC. But tell us about what you're doing, the USC Trojan Shelter.
Oh, the USC Trojan Shelter is really wonderful, and that is a student-driven idea. I mean, that's something I really touched by. They decided that they got help from the School of Social Work, and it was their determination that really pushed that forward. You know, and they're making a shelter for people that need beds. You know, we have this great street medicine program, for example. That's another idea that people have working over at the School of Medicine. So they're out meeting people where they are, giving them their medical care. And of course, all the medical students are part of that too. Because I think this interaction with students solving these great problems are what give me hope for the future.
Dr. Folt, beyond the academics, here at USC, what are the other skills that you are giving to these kids to make them employable, to make them a valuable member of our society, of our workforce?
Well, we have amazing success. Our students, I think, go out and do phenomenal things. And so we know that they're getting jobs. They get all the best practices of the day. That's one piece. A second one, though, is that they learn how to work in a group. You know, the best jobs, the people that everyone wants in a job are people that can work with other people. So they have to be socially competent. They need to be people that respect other people, that have learned what it means to be part of a multicultural society. And I think they get that by participating in all these student organizations and choral ensembles and living in these very diverse communities. And I think that makes them want, you know, a student, they're gritty, they understand how to work in a team, and they got all the cutting edge tools.
Do you give yourself marching orders for this place that you are now caretaker of?
I do. I think a lot about, it's a people-centered work, so you need to make sure that your relationships with people, students for me at the core, but also my staff and faculty, are we doing human-centered, purpose-driven work? I think about that, and I think about, are we making changes so that every week is better than the week before, every month better than the month before, and are we positioning them not just to be successful today, but to be the leaders of the future?
Coming up, more and more people throughout the Southland are getting digital library cards. And that's good for reading, right? So why are some publishers unhappy about it?